Hey guys, Severin back here, and today I am reviewing Final Fantasy 16 for the PS5. This is going to be a longer review than I normally do because this is a longer game than I normally play. This is probably the longest game I've ever played that I've finished. But anyway, I'm going to go over the same five categories I always do: graphics, performance, gameplay slash story, replayability, fun factor. Give each category a score from 1 to 10, average them up, and then talk about the game a little bit. So, just to get this out of the way, I don't really talk about spoilers, and I won't talk about spoilers in the story, but you will see footage from the game, all the way through the game, really. I mean, up until the end. Nothing story related towards the end, but characters. So, my point is, there may be spoilery material that you see, but I will not talk about spoilers in the story. So that's just your warning, watch at your own risk. But so let's start off with, if this is a RPG, an action RPG, they've gotten away from the turn-based RPGs of the past, like, the older Final Fantasies 1 through what, 10, I think. But anyway, I've only played 15 was my first Final Fantasy. This is my second one I finished. 7 was the first I played, but never did finish as a kid. But anyway, so I'm used to the combat style and I really enjoy it. But anyway, let's start with graphics. So as you can see here, the graphics, man, are just insanely good. They are stylized, the character models and things like that are not trying to look photorealistic, but they look incredible. You can play this game at 4K 30, which just looks amazing. I don't watch reviews prior to reviewing games of my own, but I did watch Digital Foundry's synopsis of, how the game runs, and they said that they think the developers intended for the 4K 30. They intended for players to play on that mode. They do have a performance mode, which I'll talk about when I get to the performance, but you can see right here the graphics are just outstanding. They just blow you out of the water to me. 10 out of 10 graphics. The colors are a bit muted. It's like realistic, but for a JRPG realistic, like textures look amazing. Skin, everything looks so good. Like you can see shiny parts of the armor up against, fabric, it looks so good, so good. But like I said, it's a stylistic thing they're going for, so like the character models don't look photorealistic, but for what the style they were going through for, I think they just knocked it out of the park. It looks insanely good. I love the effects when you fight, all the colors going on when you fight. Now that's not muted. When I say muted, I mean like the backgrounds, they're more realistic, like the greens, and it's not really what's the word I'm looking for? Saturated and that kind of thing. Everything looks more realistic. Like the leather, the red looks. It's just not super saturated. Looks great though. Anyway, next category is performance. Now this one, I really thought this through, and it debated a bunch of these categories. So I started off the game at 4K 30, and there's two different performance modes. You can choose that, 4K 30 or the performance mode, which is a variable. It varies. So when combat is fluid at 60, it looks great, feels great, but environments really, you'll see it dip. So you can choose, you can choose to have a stable 30 at 4K, and it may be, I don't know all the ins and outs of the, checkerboard rendering, blah 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 blah, but from what I know, it's 4K 30, or it's like it scales, the resolution scales. Sorry, I had to cut for a second, but like I said, the frame rate and the resolution scale in performance, but the graphics are insane. So when you put it on performance, the environments are super lush. There's a ton of vegetation. There's so much detail in the environments, and it will dip. I mean, I don't know for a fact, but it seems like it goes, like, I don't know, to the 20s or something. It really dips. But I mean, look at how beautiful that is. I prefer this mode because combat is super fluid. The environments, they push the PS5. They really do. So I still give performance category a 10 out of 10. Anyway, so I just wanted to, with that caveat, if you're fine with playing at 30 frames a second, it doesn't personally bother me, especially in a game like this with swords. It's no like precision shooting or anything like that. So I'm fine with 30, but I prefer the performance because combat just feels better at 60. Oh, excuse me. So anyway, the next category is going to be gameplay slash story, and I'll have the most to say about this category. So, okay, we'll start with the story. Man, blew me away. It really did. It's one of the best stories in a game ever that I've ever seen. In fact, I'm struggling to think of another game that can compete with this story-wise. It's so well told. It's awesome. The beginning, middle, end, it's amazing. I don't get emotional very often, but this game really had me on the verge. It is so well told. The voice acting is so good. It is so good. I don't put music as a category because normally it doesn't have a big impact on me, but the music in this game, it hits at the right time. There's so many different tracks. It's awesome. There's music to collect in the game. You can play it at your little jukebox back at your hideaway. It is just so good. So good. So well told. Characters are awesome. The voice, like I said, the voice actors do a great job. This game is so well done. Money was put in time and talent was put into this game, and it clearly shows in the story. Amazing. But here's where I'm going to dog the game just a little bit. So the gameplay is great, and it was fun, but it is too easy. The game is just too easy. The only time I died was when I wasn't paying attention. It got to the point where combat is amazing and could be, but you have these attachments you can add to yourself, and you'll see you can have like three attachments. And there's three that you get that just, if you don't use them, it just, you have the option, for instance, to have it auto block for you or prompt you to block, auto use potions. You have a dog, Torgel, which I love this game because of the dog. Okay, well, as soon as I saw that they had a dog as like your sidekick, I was just in heaven, man. I love my dog. My dog looks like Torgel, kinda. I just love the characters, including the dog. But anyway, combat is just too easy. There's one where you can literally just spam square, and it'll use it'll fight for you, use your abilities. I'm not joking. I tried to videotape myself playing, and I should have gotten my wife to just video me playing with one hand. All you need is block and square and R1, and you can literally just sit there. And I'm scrolling on, social media, whatever, just playing the game with one hand. And just that's just it's just a bummer because that is the gameplay, and it's too easy. I died two or three times, and I swear it was one time was I actually died because I fought an enemy I probably shouldn't have fought. Other than that, I died because I wasn't paying attention. I was like on the phone or something. Like, because the story is awesome and I will not scroll or do anything during a story. But like, even a fight like this, a boss fight, easily one-handed. And that's just, now you can take those things off and play the game, I guess, and make it harder on yourself. But they provide those things in the game. So it just doesn't make a whole lot of sense not to. I did take it off. And switch up my gear a little bit just to get a few trophies. But other than that, most people are not gonna switch it up a whole lot. They give you so many things that just, the enemies are tough if you didn't have those abilities. So I think that they should have had a difficulty setting, or I don't know, man. They should have done something about the difficulty. Because it's a really bummer, man. This would have been one of my favorite games. And it is. It's still high up there. Now, this is the only category where I have some negative stuff to say. So just hang in there with me. But it is so easy that challenge, it adds a lot to a game. If you know you're not going to get killed, the enemies aren't. It's just, doesn't get your heart pumping. I don't know, man. It's just too easy. And that's a delicate balance, you know, that developers have, and I understand that. But there's a mode that's called like cinematic mode or something. Are you joking? Like, to where it's even easier than this? If people play it in that mode, it's why not just watch the cutscenes on YouTube? I just don't understand. It's easy as enough as it is. There's anyway, I just don't understand that. It's already on easy mode, and then you're gonna switch it to just like butterfly mode. I mean, come on, man. It's just come on. I don't know. That could have been changed, I think, and should have been changed. Anyway, so the gameplay loop is addicting, though. You can upgrade your gear, upgrade your character. You have all these icons, which are like godlike abilities that you use. You can see right here, you hold R2, and then you use whatever, Rising Flames. You get a whole lot more. I won't ruin anything for you, but you get a whole lot of different powers. You can switch between them, but like I said, there's an ability or an item that literally you just hit square. It'll switch between the abilities for you. It'll use the abilities when they need to be used. Your dog, you can also control manually, Torgel, and he can heal you, fight for you. There's an item that makes him do all that for you. So that's the one I use. That, the dog automation, I guess. I use the basically fight. You just hit square to fight. Other than if you didn't do that, you'd have to be constantly switching between, and you can manually switch between icons and use your different abilities manually, and I do that, but you don't have to. You can just let the game do it for you. It's I don't know, man. They're just nerfing games too much for making everybody gets a trophy kind of stuff. It's pitiful. They should make this game take those items away or make the game harder or something, and I'll get into that. And replayability, there are modes opened that make the game harder, supposedly, afterwards. But story is a 10. Gameplay, I give it a 7.5 for gameplay / story. And that's pitiful, because it's a 10 story, but the gameplay just is so pitifully easy that it really takes away from the experience and ruined a lot of my enjoyability of the game. Getting past that. So gameplay / story, 7.5. Replayability, normally I'm really, really tough on this category, but this game opens, I spent 60, right at 70 hours on this game. I did every single side mission in the game, every single one. I fought, you get these like bounties, you go after different, I did 90% of those only because I couldn't find the other ones, but I'll go back and do them. To platinum this game, and this adds to the replayability to me. I love that they added this, though. They add New Game Plus, and it's called Final Fantasy Mode. It makes everything tougher. You get to keep your gear. So that right there, it's a 70, it's a 140-hour game now. You have these different pillars you find throughout the game, and you can, I'm not sure exactly what they're called, but you fight through them, and you have to beat them in a certain time limit. And if you do certain moves, they give you more time. Kind of adds a little arcade value to it, so you can try to beat them faster. And then you can go back to your hideout, and they could do them again. So it's really neat. They added that stuff. I love that. So replayability, I'm going to give a 9. Super high for me. And see, now we're going to get to replayability. Let's talk about difficulty there. So if the game is significantly harder, I mean, it would make the gameplay / story category higher, but I spent 70 hours playing the game. I mean, come on, man. It should have been harder in the first 70 hours. Now, if the second 70 hours are hard, that it may raise it, but it's going to lower. It should have been harder to begin with. But anyway, that is neat they added that. So for hardcore fans, you can go through and I got up to like level 47 or 48 going into the last boss. So, you know, I did all the side missions, and that may have added to the ease later on in the game, because there is a ton of side missions. And let's go ahead and I'll talk about that for a second. In gameplay / story, another reason that category is so low is because the side missions. Let's talk about that. Some of them, half of them, are great. Man, they're good. They tell great stories. They add to the story. Learn more about the characters. The other half, go kill this. Show up here. Go kill this. One mission, I'm not joking. You had to go find... This girl was upset, so you had to go cheer her up. And he's like, are flowers there? I don't know. Let's go check. So we went... I had to go travel over there, look for the flowers. They weren't there. Then come back here to talk to somebody to ask them about the flowers. Then they told us about another location. Then I had to go to that location to see if flowers were there. There they are. Then I had to come back, get her, then bring her to the flowers. It's a lot of just... Go here, talk to this person. Go here to kill that this army of dudes. So, some are great, some are not good. So, that also degraded that category to a 7.5. But, and it lowered my fun factor category, which is the next. So, replayability 9. My last category is fun factor. I described this game to my buddy as epic. The fights are epic, man. There's so many things about this game that you're just like, wow, man. The combat, the icons, these epic battles, the graphics, the landscapes. Even though this is not an open world game, all the landscapes connect. There's a lot of exploration. You'll understand when you go to one, you can kind of walk across the open world, but they split it up. Regardless, I love the way the design of the environments. I love the character. I love this game. But my fun factor, although I was having a 10 out of 10 fun most of the way through, on a graph it just scales down. Because it's almost like it gets easier and easier once you get all your powers. And once you find the powers you like, you can how you use your skill points or whatever. You can, redo your skill points at any time, no penalty. It's just too easy. So that also takes away from fun factor, so I knocked it down to an 8. But this is still one of the best games I've played this year. It's still great, but it's not one of my favorite games of all time simply because it's too easy. And I will probably replay this game one day. It's going to be a while because this is a long game. I don't think I've ever put 70 hours into a story-based game, for one playthrough ever. So I did enjoy it. I had fun. An 8. So just to recap, graphics a 10, performance 10, gameplay/story 7.5, replayability a 9, fun factor an 8. That averages out to an 8.9 out of 10. I haven't watched any reviews, and I'm super excited to do that to see if other people agree with me. Some notes I wrote. Quicker cinematic evasions. Oh, okay, so... Another thing, too easy. So, like, cinematic evasions, you'll hit square, and the circle will go like this. I mean, I could go in the bathroom and come back and hit square. It's too easy. Then you evade R1. You have like, 10 seconds to push a button. It's like they're quick time events, but they're just so slow. It's like a toddler could do it. It's too easy. I just don't know what they were thinking. The game should have been tougher at first. I wrote that. Major frame drops, and there is, you'll experience that in performance mode, but I still gave performance a 10 because you have the opportunity to play it at, you know, a stable 30 at 4K. So it doesn't bother me, but I wanted to mention it. More use of the DualSense, that's another thing I think, let me just explain. I'm just critiquing the game at this point. Like, it's a very well made game, it's very fun, it's a good game, but there's some things I would definitely change. More DualSense. So this is an amazing controller. The only time they used the adaptive triggers was to open doors. That's it. Big doors, you just have to hold it. You know, I think that could have been used. Although the vibration and the haptics were great throughout the game, I think they could have done more, like maybe an epic spell or something. You could use the triggers, something. I think that could have been used a little better. Awesome ending, I wrote. The ending was epic, as are just like the boss battles. There's a lot about this game. If you could describe this game in two words, it'd be easy and epic. The game is amazing. I wouldn't skip it at all. $70, it's worth the price. It's a long game. And it's a good game. Oh, there's no fishing. That's another thing that's kind of odd. I thought fishing was in every Final Fantasy game. Not in this one. 15 had fishing. If you asked me what game I liked better, this or 15, I don't remember 15 being this easy. That is my biggest critique of this game. such a bummer. This would have easily been a 9.8 or maybe even a 10 out of 10 game for me if it wasn't so easy. So that's my main critique of the game. But overall, it is a very well-made game, very good game. I don't regret playing it at all. I had a good time, even though it was easy because the story was great. But yeah, that's my review of Final Fantasy 16. If you're still here, thanks for sticking around. Server and out.